First of all, I'm very disappointed because most of my followers are Muslim and most of the comments that were coming was why are you so dark, you look ugly. Arabs and South Asians, Middle Eastern people in general, find it okay to be so racist. And most of you guys are Muslim.
What's your name, bro?
Nice to meet you, I'm Nizzy.
Nizzy, how you doing, bro?
I'm all right.
Right, fire away, man.
All right, my first question. Why do you think the information about blacks being sold in the Arab world is not mainstream news?
I don't think it goes with the mainstream narrative. I feel like blacks and Arabs are a quote-unquote minority, right, in wherever they go.
Yes.
That's what they're classed as. And so what I find is minorities generally try to group together and say, look, we're all minorities, we're all going for the same thing. And I think, personally, I don't think people are ready to kind of, you know, say, okay, but we are all a minority, but I tend to find that black people become the minority's minority.
Yeah,
do you know what I mean?
Yeah,
that,
yeah.
Like,
that's
they,
even
we
worse.
Become the
yeah.
minority's minority. So while we are a minority, like when we go to the Arab lands, you know, as you said, I've shown the video on my channel.
Yeah,
do you know what I mean?
Video.
You see
that
the video?
Quite deep, yeah.
And it's like, we are the minority in their lands. And it's like, I don't know. And I'd also think there's a game being played. I think minorities play a game of knowing that black people want to unify
with them. Yeah.
With them.
Nowhere can you buy a black person in this world except for the Arab Muslim world. You can't buy no black people no more. Black people are on auction blocks in Europe, but they're on auction blocks in the Muslim Arab world though.
We're ushered into one of two auctions happening on this same night. Crouched at the back of the yard, a floodlight obscuring much of the scene. One by one, men are brought out as the bidding begins. 400. 500. 550. 600. 650. 700. Very quickly, it's over.
And they kept bringing out what they kept referring to in Arabic as al-budaa, the merchandise. All in all, they admitted to us that there were 12 Nigerians that were sold in front of us. And I...
Take your black ass over to Saudi Arabia, see how they treat you. Take your black ass over to the Muslim world, see how they treat you. Yeah, even to Pakistan, Libya. Don't talk shit to me, bro.
Be my woman, girl. Be your man. Be my woman, girl. Be your man.
On va les Africains là-bas.
They sell Africans over there. In Libya, they sell men. Even 15-year-old Libyans are there in a car. They're armed. They'll come and kidnap you, and they'll sell you for $70 to $150. And then others will resell you.
People are suffering. People are dying.
A man addressing an unseen crowd. Big strong boys for farm work, he says. 400. 700. 700? 800. The numbers roll in. These men are sold for 1,200 Libyan pounds, $400 a piece.
I'm not even denying colonization, enslavement, but you know what's funny about white people? You will speak to them, yeah, and they will say, oh, you know what, yeah, I know, it's fucked, I know, I'm sorry, it wasn't me. They will have some kind of remorse. Speak to Muslims about Africans being enslaved. Speak to them and see what they say. Oh, well, it wasn't like that. It was like this. When you were a slave, you were treated well. And I'm like, these motherfuckers still trying to justify. They're still trying to justify this shit. They're still trying to justify it.
It wasn't just like, oh, you conquered us, just have sex with us. Many men, they didn't view slaves in that manner. because there was also male slaves as well. So they didn't view them in that manner. So they used to take care of them. They had to take care of them, and they had to feed them and clothe them and also provide for them.
Okay, so you think it's okay if people come into Mecca, kill everybody and have sex with Khadija, that's okay for you?
The premise I start with is Islam is true. So I'm saying is...
if a Muslim does it, it's okay. If somebody else does it, it's not okay.
Yeah, pretty much.
As soon as you arrive in Libya, the first thing that happens is that you are taken away and sold. Our black brothers from West Africa, wherever you are from, a Malian, a Senegalese, or any other nationality from the West, even an Ivorian, you are sold. And for what? $700.
Other migrants now start to come forward with their stories.
They took people to work by force. Even where we are at the seaside, where we are working the work, they will be beating you. When you are working the work, I'm doing your work. They will be maltreating us.
Another man, claiming to be a buyer. Off camera, someone asks, what happened to the ones from Niger? Sold off, he's told.
The term slave is synonymous with black. Instead of saying, oh, that bunch of black guys over there, they will say that bunch of slaves over there.
Literally had a non-black Arab girl today use the word Abid right in front of me, and then I was like, hold up, pause, time out, what'd you say? She's like, no, I'm not talking about you, you know, I'm talking about those people. Like, what do you mean, those people? Do you not see that I am black as well? Black as hell?
They are still being called by their ancestral names, slaves. Black Iraqis who have lived for hundreds of years in the southern province of Basra say they are discriminated against.
There are traditions in the society. People might say it doesn't exist, but we feel it. For example, when two people fight in the street, one is black and the other one is white. They say X had a fight with a slave. It really hurts.
Sha'ban is a member of the Movement for Free Iraqis. He advocates for more rights for black Iraqis, like parliament representation and more jobs. He says there's a conspiracy against them.
Why is there no black merchant or a senior black official in the state? We concluded that there's no place for the black in the Iraqi society or in the state.
They live in poverty and on the margins of society, working in low-paid professions.
And I'm like, that doesn't make you think a certain way. That doesn't make you think, hang on a minute, that's f***ed up.
فكان الأسود وما يزال ينظر له نظرة العبد ونظرة نظرة الدونية التي أورثها موروثها من السابق ولغاية الآن فينظر إلى الإنسان الأسود إنه أقل قيمة وأقل أهمية وكأنه حملا متروكا لا أحد يعيره أي اهتمام حتى السياسيين حتى الكتاب حتى الباحثين لم يعطوا الإنسان وقضايا الإنسان الأسود أي أهمية
أنا أكون عبد
There's nothing in you that stirs as a black man and says, you know what, I can't be treated like this.
Oh, freedom.
Brothers, we're not black. Let's stop talking like we're black. Let's talk in a decent way with decent manners. Allah doesn't like. Allah says, you don't know.
And don't forget. The house nigga.
قلت إنه إنك كنتم عند واحد اسمه ضيف الله الهندوة وبعدين توفى وتقاسموكم هل أنت تشعر إنك ممتلكة ملكي سيدة ولا ما أنتش ملكه؟
لا ملك.
ها؟
لا ملك.
أنت ملك سيدة تشعر أنت نفسك؟
كنت أشعر أني مجبر على أنك تشعر. مجبر على أنك تشعر.
يعني انك ملك مثل الغنم مثل اي حاجه صح
مجبور لانك تشعر بهذا الشعور
ومن اكثر واحد قسوة عليكم منهم
اكثر واحد
قاسي كم عمره ذا
عمره 19
ومن معه
اختي
اختك هي يا عمرها 16 سنه صح هو عمره 19 سنة، هل ممكن مثلا يوم يتحرش بها يعني زي هكذا أشياء؟
ما أعرف.
ها؟
ما أعرف.
ليش؟
The thing is, Mauritania, I think with Mauritania in North Africa only outlawed slavery in 2007. Okay, so yeah, they were late. Like, North Africa's been very late on the abolition of the slave stuff, you know? And so, which is why it still goes on today, because if you only outlawed it in like 2007 or something like that, of course we're going to find it in Libya in 2017. Like, it's only 10 years.
Mauritania, in 1981, became the last country in the world to abolish slavery. There was no punishment for slave owners until 2007. The UN says 10 to 20% of Mauritanians live in slavery today. The UN says 10 to 20% of Mauritanians live in slavery today. The UN says 10 to 20% of Mauritanians live in slavery today. We traveled to the country on the western fringe of the Sahara to see for ourselves. We would meet people who never knew freedom, people who escaped to find their lives hadn't changed, and abolitionists who have been fighting against slavery for years with minimal results. We weren't allowed to be reporting on slavery. It's a practice the government tries to hide from outsiders. But as we would find, slavery is everywhere in Mauritania, if you know where to look.
Les chaînes, c'est pour les captifs. Les chaînes, c'est pour l'esclave qui vient de devenir esclave. Mais l'esclave descendant de plusieurs générations, il est esclave même dans sa tête. Et il est totalement soumis. Et c'est malheureusement ce genre d'esclavage que nous avons aujourd'hui. Celui dont rêvait le planteur américain.
One woman we met is trying to bring her case to court. The government is keeping a close eye on her to stop her from telling her story.
يبطنا مسرحنا بايقة من الحيوان البقار والغنم والبن وظلوا السراحة ما من أين نجي نعود مطيشين شي من البيوان الله شي تريف يخبط فوقنا التعمار ويبطنا البط الشديد وباني بنا كاملين شاكين كان يبطني بعد يبطني كاملين يبطنا بالعمد والدبابيس وندور فيهم حقنا كاملة.
You can't have true consent in such a scenario. Masters and slaves.
الحرب من النساء هم مثلين بمعنى ان عشان اجلهم.
You can't have true consent in such a scenario. Masters and slaves.
بيصبحوا ملكا للقائد او للجيش او للمسلم.
Crook! والله you're a crook. You are a crook. You are a crook.
يستمتع بهم كما يستمتع بزوجته.
Problems like these are even more obvious when one leaves the religion and stops making excuses for this immorality masquerading as religious virtue.
كان يبطني بعد يبطني كاملين يبطنا بالعمد وب الدبابيس وندور فيهم حقنا كاملة.
So disrespectful! That shit got me so hot!
والله ما كنت تركها لا تركتهم ولا مخالدين. لا تركتهم ولا لكن مخالدين.
Where was the outcry? Like, where's the outcry in the amongst black people in the Arab Muslim world when you can see, we can see from out from where we are that there's still slavery going on with black people and Muslim Arabs. Where is the outcry within the actual community, within the black community, within Islam? It's like they don't care about it. It's like they're just used to that that being their status. And it's like, there's no, it's like there's, their pride's gone. And it's a shame to me. Like, it's actually a shame.